Have you ever used a steel on a project and found after the fact that it was just woefully inadequate and vowed never again to use that particular steel?
No, I usually test my stuff first. Somebody sends me a new flavor of the month steel, I'll test it. And it either performs or it doesn't.
There are a lot of different steels out there, and a lot of different steel fads. I usually prefer a harder steel that's more wear resistant. Lately, I've been a big fan of CTS XHP and also CPM 20CV. I favor the XHP just because I've always loved D2, so being very similar, that's helpful.
I love metallurgy, but without going into too much detail on why I choose specific steels, I love testing different steels. So to start with just the steel, before I ever see it on a knife in public that I'll sell, I end up testing the steel, I'll make a knife out of it, and I'll carry it for at minimum a month and beat it up as much as I possibly can because I want to understand what the steel is capable of, what it can do. So what I look for a lot in steels, I want a stainless knife.
I always stick with stainless steels. I don't like having corrosion issues with knives. Titanium goes along with that. You're never gonna have any corrosion issues. It holds up really well. It's relatively easy to machine. Fitting parts, they stay very stable at temperature.
Well, titanium is pretty well settled at this point. 6AL 4V titanium is the pretty good standard, and that's mostly down to its spring memory, which works great in things like frame locks and liner locks because it can bend millions of times back and forth without deforming permanently.
I use a lot of very inert materials, carbon fiber, G10, things of that nature, because I don't like to have to worry about glue delaminating or just things falling apart or expanding or contracting when you don't want them to.
There's a lot of really good materials out there, but I want to know what they're going to do and how they're going to move with time. Sometimes wood and natural materials is a hard one to work with unless they're properly sealed or properly plasticized, basically. We call it stabilizing, but it's basically plasticizing the material. It's filling the cellulose pores with plastic so that it can't absorb moisture. And finding quality woods like that is actually pretty hard. Wood can ebb and flow and with changes in humidity and changes in moisture content. So if I use wood, I have to test that sort of thing.
So how do I choose materials? Depends on the project. What am I doing? You know, what kind of knife am I making? How is it going to be used? And then I test every piece of steel there is, every new thing, flavor of the month steel that's out there, and I test it to its fault. It's essentially a lot of rattan, a lot of beading, heavy whittling, cardboard, corrosion resistance tests, toughness tests. I find out what it excels at or whether it excels at all. And then I defeat the blade. I break the blade and I check out the grain structure of the steel.
A lot of guys use backyard testing, is my term. It's where I do certain things in my own facility to see whether bend, flex will break a knife, whether certain things chipping, damaging. But my data then isn't comparable with the rest of the world. So I like using standards. So if I use a standardized test method, which we're a California certified test facility with ultrasound, mag particle, eddy current, all those methods. So we have the ability to do all of those things. And by doing so and doing them to standards that provide comparable data, meaning that if I do it here and I send my data to the steel mill themselves, they use the same equipment and the same criteria to accomplish their data.
I don't trust data from anyone except myself. I use their data as a starting point, but I want to know what it's actually capable of. So even with steel companies, I'll look at their data sheets, I'll look at the chemical makeup, and I have a pretty good understanding after all these years of making knives and studying them as much as I can of what the steel is going to do beforehand, but I still have surprises. AEBL is a perfect example of one that has very pleasantly surprised me. If you look at its makeup and its structure, it should be a mediocre steel, but it outperforms its chemistry. It's an incredibly robust steel that can take an enormous amount of beating and hold an edge wonderfully, and it's still easy to sharpen. And it's incredibly rust resistant. So it's one that the testing I did on it completely blew me away. It outperformed what it says it should do.